why you should be concerned with cloud security, right? Cloud is a big subject. If you think about that, the CIOs and the CTOs, they should be very worried about security in the cloud. They should be very cautious, and they, of course, are investing a lot in security because that's how you can keep your data safe. If you keep the data safe, you're keeping all the company property safe as well, right? Of course. So all the company data is located in the cloud, so it's going to be moved, right? Of course, a lot of companies assume are moving to the cloud, but for the companies which are already in the cloud, the data is already there in the cloud. So it should make sure that the data security is in place so that there's no breaches or attacks that could compromise the data of the companies, right? And if you think about cloud is a very nice space where the hackers could compromise very easily data from the companies, right? Because the reason for it is, if you think about that, in order to access any resource in the cloud, the only thing that you need to have, if you don't have, of course, multi-factor authentication in place, is only your username and a password. And then once you have the username and a password and the URL of the cloud provider, anybody can go there and log into the tenancy, right? So that's why it is best practice, of course, to have multi-factor authentication enabled so that, you know, you can have more than one way to authenticate yourself, and that will be helpful for preventing access of unauthorized people in your tenancy, right? But let's say that you'd like to see what's going on, who is logging into your tenancy, who is, you know, being granted to access your resources, or which kind of operations those users are doing in your tenancy, right? How do you do these things in OCI? Is there any way to do it? Maybe you're wondering, right? And the answer is yes. By using the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Audit Service, you can basically audit everything that is going on in your tenancy. So what the audit service does is, it basically captures all the API calls that, you know, a user is making against your tenancy. And if you think about that, right, even if you use the UI, the user interface in your browser, at the end of the day, the browser is translating all the requests to HTTP requests, and that is going to be translated to an API call at the end of the day, right? So at the end of the day, everything is an API call, whether it is a UI or a CLI, everything will be a HTTP call against the API endpoint, right? That's why when anybody does anything in the OCI, it is going to be captured, and then from that event, it is going to generate a audit event so that you can see which kind of activities were going on, you know, given moment in time in your tenancy, right? And that is the use case, of course, that is the main use case that you want to use the audit service in OCI, so that you can see what is going on inside of your tenancy in a given moment of time, right? Let's say that you'd like to see or to understand better who is creating instances in your tenancy, or who is listing your instances in the OCI, in the compartments in the OCI, right? You can see all these things using the audit service of Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, right? Or let's say that you'd like to understand what is the source IPs, the source of the users which are logging into your tenancy. You can do it with audit service as well. It is basically a very granular way to do the audit in your tenancy in OCI.